Were there any alarms that were in the override position?
None that I'm aware of.
Do you know why this was inhibited on the Deepwater Horizon system?
When I discovered it was inhibited about a year ago, I inquired as to why it was inhibited. And the explanation I got was that from the OIM down, they did not want people woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning due to false alarms.
Any new developments in the cleanup effort?
Well, I think the thing that's outrageous is that we only have 20 skimmers off the coast of Florida. There are 2,000 skimmers in the United States. We haven't even asked as a federal government for those skimmers to come to the Gulf. We have these huge swaths of oil right off our beaches that could really ruin our way of life in North Florida. And the federal government, who wants to take over every other aspect of our life, can't get this one thing right that they should be doing right. So I've talked to the president about it. He doesn't seem to know the situation about foreign skimmers, domestic skimmers. They said to me, look, you know, some of these skimmers we can't take from other places in the country because they may need them for an oil spill. That's like, you know, me saying, well, I can't send the fire truck to your house that's burning down because another house may burn down. It just doesn't make any sense. So
you're saying we have the capability of cleaning up this mess right now. Obama's just dropping the ball.
He is. We have 2,000 skimmers in this country, plus foreign countries. The Dutch came into my office yesterday and said, we have these super skimmers. We've been offering them. And the U.S. government is saying no. There was a report out from Associated Press this week that 21 offers of assistance from 17 countries have been denied. It's just beyond comprehension that we wouldn't use all the resources we can to clean up this oil. So I'm going to keep banging on it.
And with the current sensitivity about oil, a spill in Michigan is getting a lot of attention. A leaking pipeline that sent oil into a creek that feeds the Kalamazoo River. And while booms have been deployed, an estimated 848,000 gallons of oil has already escaped here. Trails of oil sheen can be seen all the way downriver, far from the bulk of the spill. It's coming from a 30-inch pipe that runs from Indiana to Ontario, owned by a Canadian company, Enbridge. It carries 8 million gallons a day. Officials say they don't know what caused that pipe to start leaking yesterday.
Michigan Governor Jennifer Granholm has sharply criticized the Environmental Protection Agency and the Canadian company Enbridge for what she's described as a completely inadequate response to Tuesday's oil spill near the Kalamazoo River. More than 800,000 gallons of oil have spilled into Michigan waterways after the rupture of an underground oil pipeline carrying Canadian oil into the United States. Concern is now growing. The oil could reach Lake Michigan. The Detroit Free Press reports the company that owns the pipeline, Enbridge, was notified twice this year of potential problems of involving old pipe prone to rupturing and an inadequate system for monitoring internal corrosion. The spill is believed to be one of the largest in the history of the Midwest. In news on the BP oil spill,
Matthew, Kathy Simmons is founder of the Ocean Energy Institute. He joins us on the phone. And Matt, thanks so much. Always good to talk to you again. I know you were hearing what Lizzie was saying.
Yeah.
Some of the information that I'm seeing here in our Bloomberg story, the pressure inside that well is now over 6,800 pounds per square inch since it was sealed on July 15th. Does that give you cause for concern?
No, it's a total diversion.
Why do you say that?
That's the gas condensate that was trapped in the drilling riser, which blew off the wellhead at 10:01 a.m. or p.m. Central Standard Time on April 20th. That's a mile-long compressed natural gas. What
right.
we don't know anything about is the open hole, which is caused by the drill bit, when they tossed the blow-up preventer way out of the hole and all the casing out of the hole, and we're flowing 120,000 day minimum of toxic poison. Is now covered the bottom of the Gulf of Mexico.
Right.
So what they're talking about is the biggest environmental cover-up ever. And they knew that riser would finally deplete.
Right.
And then they could say it's over. And unfortunately, we now have killed the Gulf of Mexico.
So Matt, you're saying that this is Lizzie O'Leary, you're saying those pressure readings that they are saying are coming from inside that wellhead just aren't valid?
No, they're the riser pipe.
Right.
It's attached to the rig floor.
And you're saying that's simply a diversion from actually getting a decent reading down near...
Some 5 to 10 miles away is what the NOAA research vessels have now proved is a deep oil lake that's growing by the day. And it's very toxic oil, and its gases are very lethal. And basically, if we have a hurricane now, we need to evacuate the Gulf Coast.
Matt, we have about 30 seconds left. Talk to me about the implications for BP. Is bankruptcy in their future? Is that something?
Listen, when people find out the magnitude of the story, I don't know we can technically clean up the Gulf, but it would cost at least $1 trillion.
As you look back, April 20th was when this accident happened. As you look back and reflect on this, what were your concerns?
The Attorney General of Texas has launched an investigation into a massive release of toxic chemicals from BP's oil refinery in Texas City. The toxic release began on April 6 and continued for 40 days. BP now estimates 538,000 pounds of chemicals escaped from the refinery during that period. The chemicals included nitrogen oxides, benzene, carbon monoxide, propane, isobutane, and other emissions. The daily release of benzene was 40 times the state reportable levels. Yahoo News.
I've just issued a declaration of emergency, which will help speed up state assistance to parishes in need of supplemental assistance for their efforts. We understand that at least 7 parishes will also be declaring a state of emergency today due to this event. Those are Lafourche, Acadia, Calcasieu, Cameron, Jefferson Davis, St. Mary, and Vermilion Parish. They've informed us.
So, I mean, it really almost makes you ask the question, would it have been better if we'd never invented the Internet and had to use paper and pencil or whatever? And that's a stupid thing to say, but it has genuine consequence.
First story is censored news. People bleeding internally, millions poisoned, said EPA whistleblower. This is last name Kaufman, EPA whistleblower of Democracy Now. Oh, Mark Kaufman. He says, we have dolphins that are hemorrhaging. People who work near it are hemorrhaging internally. This is the oil spill. And that's what the dispersants are supposed to do. In its report, EPA whistleblower accuses agency of covering up effects of dispersant in BP oil spill cleanup. Democracy Now! States that, quote, many lawmakers and advocacy groups say the Obama administration is not being candid about the lethal effects of the dispersants. So Amy Goodman interviewed Hugh Kaufman, a senior policy analyst at the EPA's Office of Solid Waste and Emergency Response, a leading critic of the decision to use Corexit 9500, this is the main dispersant they're using, who disclosed how the officials are lying about many things related to the catastrophe poisoning millions of people. Now this is, I'm picking these stories on purpose, where we've got senior policy analysts at EPA. We've got people that have a lot of credentials are coming forward saying this. It's not just some one person putting up a story regarding the Gulf. These are actually people that have a lot more experience with this than I do. And there's a real audio link I give you here where you can click and listen to this interview with this EPA whistleblower. The transcript includes Kaufman saying, quote, and I think the media now has to follow the money, just as they did in Watergate, and tell the American people who's getting money for poisoning the millions of people in the Gulf.
At the beginning of this year, there were a lot of sinkholes. Now check this out. A 4 feet deep, 600 feet long crack opened up in the earth, I believe in Michigan, overnight. That's scary. Trees that were pointing straight up in the air were now pointing 15 degrees off.